Hello and welcome to the first instalment of Cooking with the Random Kid Online. Today we'll be learning how to cook some sausages. First of all, what you want to do is defrost some. I've already done it. And here they are. After you've defrosted them, if you want them to cook real nice, you would need to cut them up like this. Getting a knife, make sure you separate them properly. This knife should only be used for the meat products. So you need to cut them up like this. Just like that. Now you want to do this to all of them. After you've done that, you will want to always wash your hands. Now you'd like to turn on your pan to max heat so they can cook up the fastest. So it should be this one that's heating up. So now you want to take your pan, take a little bit of oil and put a little bit on. About 1 teaspoon. After that, you want to spread it with this so it's nice and even. As you can see, things are starting to heat up here. So now what we want to be doing is tossing our sausages. We're going to be using our spatula. We want to be putting them in there, position them where we want them to be the best cooks, and we observe. Meanwhile, we want to be cutting up the salad using a different knife. This, I'm going to have a little bit of cucumber with some cherry tomatoes. As we can hear, the sausages are sizzling. That is a good sign. That means they're starting to cook. We're going to get our cherry tomatoes and cut them in half. Because we don't want them to be a mouthful. Our salad sorted. We can move on to the cooking. Now you can see they're sizzling and heating up. That's the water evaporation from the ice. We're going to turn our condenser on to 2 and switch our lamps on. Now, a good way to cook this is to throw them around a little bit, get them nice and cooked. While we're even cooking for a little bit, I like to have a separate bowl for my salad. This is our salad, and this is how I do. I like to have a bit of sauce. This is a Bulgarian traditional ludinita. It's a bit like tomato ketchup, so we're going to get a fork. Oh, and a knife for when it's ready. I'm going to leave these three. And we're just going to put a little bit inside of this sauce. A little bit at the side. Looks like I'm running low in this case. That should be enough. I'm going to leave this here. We're going to tear the tissue. There we go. And we're just going to leave this here. And go back to check them. Yep, this is cooked. Look, there's fat coming out. And then that's the process of cooking. And they should cook pretty fast now that they're on the cooking. So what we need to do is just twist them around so they cook from all sides. Make sure they're nice and tender. And they should be ready in a few minutes to come. Meanwhile, we're just going to tidy up. So what we want to do next, after it's cooked on both sides, we want to start cooking it on the third side. But this time we're going to add some salt and pepper, any spicy one. I like a bit of salt and pepper. We want to make things cool, we can squeeze it as all the fat comes out, and so does some steam. This also speeds up the process of cooking and makes a really satisfying sound. We're going to leave them there for a little bit more until they cook. We're going to put everything back where it was. Okay, so after we've tidied up, we want to roll them around a little bit until we feel as if they're ready. Want to cook them on the top. Get rid of that bit of fat because I'm not a big fan of fat. Alright, now when they look ready, nearly ready, almost ready, go ahead and switch the power. There's no more heat coming, as the pan will still be hot, and they will continue cooking. Okay, now that they look pretty ready, we can go take our bowl, our plate, I mean, and take our fork, and just put them in here. We're going to need a knife to take them off. We want to put the pan in the sink to cool down a little bit. We do not want to pour water in it instantly, as it will break, as it will destroy the Teflon wool, which keeps it non-stick. Now we can just turn off the air and put everything else for washing, which your mum can do. So, the outcome should be sausages with your sauce of choice and a salad. Drop down now. So there we go. I hope you enjoyed and find this useful for cooking at home. Thank you for watching and see you later.